Of you, today we will discuss our ninth chapter about air, and it's our new lesson. In this new lesson, we will learn about air, and we all know that air is very important for all living creature, because if there will be no air, then there will be no life. All the living creatures need air for alive in this earth. Now you can see in the book that first there is an activity which you have to do yourself. Try to think of any one activity where you can feel air and write down about 50 lines which you can write in your life where you feel the air and your experience, how you have experience about air. Now here you are looking that there are different pictures in your book. First one is air help a kite to fly in the air. Now a kite fly at a height with the help of air. And again in the next figure you can see that we take in air while breathing. Yes, we take oxygen and we expel carbon dioxide. Like trees take carbon dioxide and release oxygen. And in the next you can see that air helps a boat to sail. Yes, the white color one is made up of white cloth which help to cut the water by boat for moving in the forward direction. The air give a pressure to that cloth and very smoothly the ship cut the water and move frequently. Now we all know that air is also all around us. Yes, air is present all over us, but we cannot see. Yes, we can't see it, only we can feel it. Now we can feel moving air when we run. We can feel the air pushing as in our a force. Suppose when you run in field or in any park, then you can see a pushing pressure as in yourself. Plants, animals and human need air to live. All the creature needs air for living purpose. Now air is useful to us in many way. We all know that this air is very important to us. Now we will discuss a topic about moving air, and this topic we will learn about the moving air. Now we can feel air when it's move. Yes, when you sit and the hot season, suppose when air comes by moving around you, you feel relaxed. Moving air is called wind. Yes, moving air is called wind. When the wind is gentle and moves slowly, it is called a breeze. I repeat again, when the wind is gentle and moves slowly, it is called breeze. When the wind is very strong and moves very fast, it is called a storm. You can see the trees, its leaves is falling down because the wind pressure is very high, and that's why it is called by the name storm. Now sometimes there is a heavy rain along with a storm. You have seen in the rainy season, and storm can damage houses and blow away their roofs. The storm can also pull trees out of the ground. Means the storm have such a power that can destroy all over the things. You have seen in your nearby surrounding area, when the weather is very bad, that time when the wind comes very strong like in cyclone type, then it destroy in a large amount and it harm us very much. It affect our economy and many things. Suppose your houses fall down, your trees damage, etc. So we have learned in this topic about the moving air.